Okay, so it's Monday, it's raining and thundering. And this is the first time that he's been all the way in there. He's just had his little head in there with his butt hanging out the rear. The last couple days of raining. Today is Monday. See, buddy just kind of pinned him a little bit for no reason. Look at him. Leave him alone, buddy. He ain't hurt nothing. So, again, since this is Monday, they've been together. This is either 7 days or if I got him Tuesday, then it's 6 days. But a little better each day. Oh, there's a little cardinal. See a little cardinal? It's raining pretty good. Buddy walked by him earlier today, and he kind of didn't yield. And Buddy was like, "What? Are you going to disrespect me?" And Buddy just reached out and tried to bite him in the butt, and Ransom took off. It was like, "Don't!" as soon as this rain stops, I know I tell people not to get involved and not try to save them, but I went out there and I just gave them an apple and a carrot, and I was standing in between them, and their noses were literally touching each other while I was giving the other one carrots and apples, and they were fine as long as I'm standing there. So as soon as this rain kind of gets down, it dries out a little bit, I'm going to tie them up and give them some tie time out here on the little tie post and make them hang out more, which I don't really need to, but I don't want Buddy to get in the habit of just pushing him, because he's never really been a herd leader. And Mr. T never pushed more than needed to. He only pushed when he had to. And Buddy, I think, because he's a little insecure, and this is a new guy, and he doesn't really know how to be a good leader, he's kind of pushing on everything. But he doesn't push when I'm around. And if Mr. T was around, Mr. T wouldn't let him push and do that to a horse. A good leader will not let another horse bully the herd or create chaos in a herd for no reason. And so if there was plenty of times there was a gelding that was acting out or harassing the mares, and Mr. T would run his butt out of the herd, and he'd be standing on the outside by himself until Mr. T let him back in. So see, there's nobody there to kind of keep Buddy in check. So I know some people will be like, there was already a couple women. I got so many hate watchers that just love to come here, watch me, and then stalk me, and then wait for their opportunity to say, "I got you." So I had a couple comments saying, "Oh, you put them together, and you're always telling women that you shouldn't put them together, and then you go ahead and do it, and you're a hypocrite." And but you know, I was like, "Oh God, you guys are freaking such idiots." So when I go out there and I kind of take the lead position and I don't let Bully or Buddy push or bully him around, I'm being a good leader when I'm out there. And that's exactly what a lead horse would do. And Buddy's an inexperienced lead horse. He's been behind Mr. T his whole life. And even when he was up the horses, Mr. T would kind of protect him and take him under his wing. So he's kind of lived, you know, his whole life. He's 17 now without having to be a leader or knowing when's enough enough. And because he only has one horse, that's another thing. He can focus all his attention on him. If he had a herd, you can't be focusing your attention on a small shit. You got to take care of the big shit, keep your herd together, make sure nobody's coming in to steal him, make sure there's no predators around. So you're busy and you don't have time to do the shit that Buddy's got time to do now because he's only got one horse. So for those that want to come here and say, "I got you," and Rick's getting involved and he tells everyone else and he's a crip, whatever, freaking idiots. I mean, once they show their colors and they put those little, I mean, I block them so I don't have to read them again because, I mean, I got up the other morning and I had like 18 comments from this one person and every one of them was negative. Every one of them was, "You're a piece of crap. I'm glad Mr. T died. It's too bad he had to be with you." I mean, it was just mean, nasty. And, you know, when you go to this person's account, of course, I go to see how long or what videos they're doing sometime. And, of course, it was newly created, some little bitter woman. Nothing else to do than make a new false account, a fake account, and come here and leave 18 freaking comments on how I was a bad owner and how I did Mr. T wrong. And just, it's just disgusting to have to deal with those people. But it is what it is. So, anyway, it's raining and they're both under there. So that's a good thing. There was a couple really good lightning and thunders, and I was going to try and get those in here so people could see the horses, how they kind of like, they don't even react. Last night, somebody was lighting off fireworks, and they were running around like, shit, the fireworks. And I think fireworks are different because they see the stream of the light, and it's high above them, and then all of a sudden, there's the boom, and there's the flickering, and I don't know if they smell it. I mean, they could smell it if the wind's in the right direction. But fireworks give them a different fear, or they know the difference between fireworks and lightning and thunder. And there's a little thunder. Man, sometimes it freaking shakes the freaking pictures on the wall. It vibrates so much. We have been getting some, my pond has never been as full as it is. It's like freaking super full. Buddy, go out there now and shit, swim it like it's an Olympic pool. He could do laps. Of course, he don't go in it when it's cold or rainy. He only goes in it when it's 100 degrees and he rolls out in the mud. So, and probably little Belle's probably over there standing in the rain. No, she must have went back to her tree or something. Sometimes she just stands out there waiting for the boys to come out in the rain. All right, well, day 6 or 7. I keep meaning to go back on when I brought him over, whether it was Monday or Tuesday. All right, well, enter.
It's Monday out here. Just finished my walk, and they're still hanging out by the fence. So, I forgot to end the last video with Mr. T and Buddy, you're a good boy. So, Buddy, Mr. T, you're a good boy.
It's been rainy here for a while. Smokey found the sun out, so he decided to come up and nap a little bit, get him some sun. Is that his leg hanging off there? It is his leg, crazy cat. He's got one leg and one tail hanging off. So it's been raining for so long, it's just been a muddy mess out here. So, oh, there's that little cardinal. See him right out there by the fire extinguisher? Right there. So this sun's coming out hopefully for today and tomorrow, and that'll let this place dry out a bit. All right, I just wanted to get Moki sunbathing since it stopped raining. I'm kind of surprised that neither of my guys are over here. So I don't know where they're at. I can't see them from the front. I wonder if they're together or if they're... At least Buddy ain't in the shed. Oh, there's Ransom. He saw me. Oh, I bet you Buddy's laying down. Buddy is sleeping. He's laying down and Ransom's looking over him. I hope Buddy's just sleeping. See if he moves. I don't want to
He's just sleeping. We're finally gonna get some sun today and hopefully dry out a little bit. I'm kind of surprised he's laying down and it's so wet and muddy, but it kind of dried up yesterday. Man, I don't see him breathing. I'm kind of getting nervous. I better call him. Buddy? Oh, shit. He was scratched. Buddy, you scared Dad. I didn't even see you breathing. Oh, shit. He's like, dude, I was freaking having all these little hussies hanging all over me. What are you guys doing? Little Ransom was looking over you like a good boy. How come you guys weren't laying by little Bell? Oh, look at him. He's got to push him first thing. He was looking over you first thing, and now you got to push him? Really? Hi, Ransom. Hi, buddy boy. Man, I'm surprised you didn't hear me call him first time. I was like, oh, shit, that ain't good. I'm always a little nervous when I worm them because some horses, usually if they're really wormy and they haven't been wormed in a while, it can cause them to colic a little bit. But he was eating and doing things. What are you doing, buddy boy? What are you guys doing? Are y'all becoming buddies yet? Y'all seem a little more buddy-ish. Don't you pin yours at him. All right, so I'm going to... Hi, bud. Hi, handsome. Holy. Oh, you got little flies on you. Oh, my goodness. There's little flies on, little buddy boy. Look at you. You're all wet over there because you were laying in the wet grass. You're all wet over there. I know. Oh, my goodness. He's a good boy. All right, let me get you guys some hay. I'm going to feed him in one pile and stand over it with you guys. Look at Buddy scratching his neck on that fence. All right, let me get you guys some hay.